It is going to stop. God is aware what is happening. But before any change takes place, God has to bring about a cleansing. He has to clean and disinfect things so that the stage is prepared for the next stage in God's operation. It's always this way. That's why I want you to see the present turmoil in the Middle East as a necessary development of a preparation for a cleansing God is going to make. Many Christians today believe that the world is eventually going to get good, that mankind is going to become refined, at least believers are, and that Christ is going to come in some mystical way and perfect human beings. That's not true. We are indeed given faith, and we're given a measure of faith, and we are light in the world as much as we are able, yet even we are still imperfect. And we look for Christ to come to clean the house, to perfect us, and it's going to happen at once. It's not going to happen gradually like some evolution. And it didn't happen gradually in the days of Noah. And Christ, as we read yesterday in Matthew 24, likens these days, the end days, likens them to the days of Noah. And there was a sudden stoppage. God said, enough, it's going to stop. Was God mad? No, I'm going to get into this too. You think God was mad and really ticked off and vengeful when the flood waters came? He wasn't. It was not an angry God. It was a God who sighed and said, it's time for this to stop for the sake of the people, for the sake of the earth, for the sake of my development of my program of the eons. And God the whole time has in mind what he's coming to. And you can only see that as we lift the viewpoint and go back, or should I say up, set your affections on things above. And as we go up and we begin to see the big picture and we see where God is going, we see that he is planning on bringing all humanity to a perfect end, all in all, reconciling all things in him. But first, he has to make humanity understand via experiences that we cannot perfect ourselves, that human government must fail, even given the best circumstances. And again, we didn't even have human government until the deluge, commonly referred to as the flood. Now, some people, again, don't even believe that Noah's Ark is true. I had priests, and when I was a kid, they told me that this is just a story. You know, there was no such thing as Noah. It's all allegorical. You know, if I see somebody with a black shirt and a white collar, to me, that's just like a sign around their neck saying, unbeliever. Not only do they not believe what Christ accomplished on the cross, but they don't believe what God said happened. Many people just spiritualize this stuff away and say, well, but if you do that, where do you stop? Were Adam and Eve really on the earth? Were they real people? Or was this just a story that was made up to give us some kind of hazy picture about how things were? No, these people and their generations occurred. And there was a man from the line of Seth who was righteous in his generation. And he was a picture of Christ. And he built a big freaking boat. And it was called a Thebe. T-H-B-E. It wasn't called an ark. That's an English word. Thebe. Love this word. You know what it means? This is really interesting. T-H-B-E. Don't ask me how to pronounce it in the Hebrew. Okay, I'll try it. Thebe. I don't know. When you put a T and an H and a B together, it's kind of hard in English. B usually has the force of in. If you put a TH in front of it, it indicates you. And an E at the end gives us a direction toward. So you put all those elements together and you get you into. You into. In, you, and to. These three elements, B, T, H, E. You into. You go into this because I'm going to preserve you. And I'm going to draw parallels for you today, this week, I should say. I'm going to draw parallels for you to see that God is telling us, you are into me. And that goes back to my first verse yesterday, that your life is hid. Oh, isn't that great? be disposed to that which is above, not to that on the earth. For you died, your life is hid together with Christ in God. You into me. God hid Noah during a time of great indignation, and God is hiding you today. That's why I want you to see the big picture. I want you to be hidden from these, from this prostitution, greed, uncleanness, all these things that are happening in the Middle East. God is hiding you in an ark today, because these are parallel times. I'm going to show you these times tomorrow. In the meantime, I'm Martin Zender. Five eons. We'll see you tomorrow.